It's March 29th, and I'm Bailey Gardner.
And I'm Jacob Latimer.
Here with this year's 19th episode of the CCN. Today we'll get into some entertainment with What's the Rage with Gage and Cage. Sports with Isaac Thatcher and his new co-host, Will Kyle. Also, Whether or Not with Seth Watkins and Will Kyle. And Imagine with Matt and Jen.
On top of all that, Bailey and I will fill you in on some important school announcements. It's time for the CCN. The biggest gun control protest in a generation was held Saturday, March 24th. Hundreds of rallies were staged across the U.S. and beyond as marchers filled the streets calling for implementation of tighter measures following the deadly mass shooting at a Florida school in February. Saturday's mass demonstrations, which took place under the banner of March for Our Lives, were led by a rally in Washington, D.C., attended by some 200,000 demonstrators. Many celebrities made an appearance at the march in Washington, such as Kanye West, Kim Kardashian, Paul McCartney, and more.
To explore how this issue affects us here at County, we went out to ask some of you about whether or not Kentucky or our country needs stricter gun control. Hey guys, it's Bailey and Jacob, your anchors of the Colonel Cast, and we're coming to you to ask you guys your opinions on the recent mass shootings in towns all across America, and we want to know what your thoughts are on what we can do to fix it, what your opinions are on gun control, and just, you know, overall what your answers are.
I'm here with
Joby Beasley.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does that make you feel about gun control?
I think something definitely needs to be done about it. I'm not exactly sure what, but this can't keep happening.
I'm here with
Ellie Parker.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does that make you feel about gun control?
I think they're definitely very, very sad, and I think that more measures should be taken to promote gun safety and safety in schools, and I think we definitely need to make a better effort to educate ourselves and the people who are coming after us so that we can make a safer environment for children at school. We shouldn't have to choose between education and our lives.
Hi, I'm Bailey, and you are?
Zach Hagan.
And what are your opinions on the recent mass shootings and gun control?
Well, recent mass shootings are showing that we have no idea how to handle mentally disabled and mentally strange people in our country. It's not guns that are a problem, because there's more guns in Switzerland per capita. And they have the lowest crime rate and have had almost no mass shootings. The problem is, we have made it to where the people who threaten other people with guns, or even something like, or even have mental disorders, can get very heavy guns very quickly. Now, it does not mean that other people should not have guns. It means that very heavy guns are very bad for this thing.
I'm here with
Gabby Shelton.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does that make you feel about gun control?
It's just really sad because my cousin was actually in Marshall County, and he was one of the few that actually made it out.
I'm here with
Maddie Riddick.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does that make you feel about gun control?
Honestly, the mass shootings make me feel really sad. I don't really have much to say about it.
I'm here with
Ja'Kai Phillips.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does it make you feel about gun control?
The recent mass shootings, they make me feel really unsafe, and it makes me feel really unstable at school that I have to fear coming to school for, like, you know, not just for my education, but, like, I have to, like, be safe for my life, too. And my thoughts on gun control are that I feel like people that aren't, like, mentally stable or, like, you know, shouldn't be able to get guns, or if there's been recent problems in the past, they shouldn't be able to, like, have control over them.
I'm here with
Tylan.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does it make you feel about gun control?
It's saddening, but it's not the guns that are doing it, it's the people.
All right, thank you. All right. I'm here with
Jacob Vaughn.
Cole Glasgow.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does it make you feel about gun control?
Well, I don't really think we need gun control. I think it's just more the people and the way kids are treated at home and like their home lives, and it's not really the guns. I mean, you can't go walk out there and a gun can't grow legs and go shoot somebody. It's the people.
I'm here with
AJ Rutledge,
Weston Melton.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does it make you feel about gun control?
Well, the recent mass shootings all has to do with the way people are treated, and it's all a people thing. It's not necessarily the guns' faults, because guns can't shoot people. Guns can't pull their own triggers. It's the people's in their minds and people that are mentally ill. We need more good people with guns and less bad people with guns to compensate for mass shootings.
I'm kind of with AJ here. The guns they don't go out and kill people themselves. There's got to be a person behind it with a mission to go out and kill. They just do what they're made to do.
All right, thank you. I'm here with
Jack Ferguson,
Austin Denham.
What are your thoughts on the recent mass shootings, and how does that make you feel about gun control?
I think the recent mass shootings are just a travesty to this nation, and I think that we do need gun control, and we can put a stop to this.
I think that we need people control, not gun control.
All right, thank you.
Thank you to all those who shared your valued opinions.
I love your sunglasses.
Thanks. I'm so happy spring break is coming up. I cannot wait to go to Hawaii.
What are you doing for spring break?
I'm here with
Lauren.
What are you planning to do for spring break?
Probably just spend a lot of time with my animals and sleep and write speeches.
Good time to catch up on some sleep.
I'm here with Shelby.
What are your plans for spring break?
Work and sleeping.
Thank you.
I'm here with
Zane Eden.
What do you plan on doing for spring break?
Mostly just like hanging out at my house and eating a bunch of food.
I'm here with
Alex Hurst.
What are you planning on doing for spring break?
Spring break, I'm planning on either going down to Florida, hanging out on the beach, or going on a road trip.
I'm here with
Thank you.
Emma Olson. What are your plans for spring break?
Sleep and do homework.
Thank you.
I'm here with
Alyssa.
What are your plans for spring break?
I'm going to head up to Lafayette to spend some time with my friends.
Thank you. I'm here with
Jackson.
What are your plans for spring break?
I'm going on a cruise.
Thank you.
With Larry.
What are you planning on doing for spring break?
Just sitting here chilling, watching Netflix, and sleeping.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody. My name is Isaac.
And I'm Will Kyle.
And we're going to talk about some sports. Before we go into national news, first we need to congratulate Ms. Ashley Durham for committing to Shawnee College softball program. The Gleaner reported that the coach is excited to have Ashley's speed on the team, which is currently rebuilding itself. Best wishes to you, Ashley, as you continue in athletic success.
We also wanted to give a shout-out to a couple of football players. Andrew Turley, who committed to Franklin College in Franklin, Indiana, and Shane Welshins for committing to Rose Holman College in Terre Haute, Indiana. Congratulations and best wishes. Now in March Madness news, the Final Four in San Antonio, Texas has been officially set with this year's Cinderella story, Loyola, Chicago, to go up against the best team, Michigan, then Villanova goes up against Kansas. These two games were set up this year's championship game.
Now let's turn the page to What's the Rage with Gage and Cage.
Yee-yee, everybody. I'm Gage Johnson.
And I'm Cage Hazelwood. Just when you thought you'd never see us again, Gage and I are back for yet another splendid segment of What's the Rage with Gage and Cage. Let's talk about some stuff.
Let's start things off with a big shout-out to the performers of last week's showing of Sweeney Todd. The acting was great, the music was beautiful, Take a moment to appreciate local arts like this because the actors, musicians, and artists of all sorts put a lot of effort into what they do for the sake of entertaining you, the people. In other news, as of last Friday, Black Panther has become the most tweeted about movie of all time with a staggering 35 million retweets. Beating Star Wars The Last Jedi was originally held at that place.
Gage and I also had the pleasure of seeing Black Panther around its release, and if I do say so myself, Black Panther delivered stunning visuals, a great story, and gave well-needed background to one of the newest MCU heroes.
Cage and I have been trying our hardest to avoid this hot garbage, but it has been inevitable that we would have to talk about this.
Oh no.
I know, Cage. Recently, a co-op sandbox survival game has been blowing up and everyone is playing it. What is this, you may ask? Well, this game is called Fortnite. Fortnite can be fun for people that are actually good at it, but if you're like me and you suck, it's not very fun at all. But in all honesty, Fortnite is fun at first, but after a while it's very repetitive and seems to be a carbon copy of the other Battle Royale games such as PUBG. It is free though, so I mean, that's a plus. We understand that some of you are going to be upset with that, with what I just said, but I mean...
Fortnite wins in the debate of whether PUBG is better than Fortnite or the other way around aren't the only things in the headlines. The second full-length trailer of Avengers Infinity War came out recently. This trailer showed new scenes and stuff not seen in the first trailer, including the Iron Spider suit, the Black Order, more scenes of Thanos fighting our heroes, and even showing some of the alliances between the many, many characters in the MCU.
On that note, we hope you all enjoyed last week's movie reviews.
Even though there was some definite shade thrown at us.
This has been What's the Rage with Gage and Cage.
Now for another edition of your weekly weather report with Seth and Will.
Have reports that you have been acting very dependable. Your co-workers claim you keep things running very smoothly.
I do, thank you.
Since this is the case, we have no choice but to subpoena you to celebrate.
Alright.
With some candy.
Woo! Thank you! What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Give this card.
Hi, guys.
You know what you did?
It says here that you are always kind and listen to students.
Says you help with any problem they have and show respect.
The charges even include dependability.
In light of these charges, you have been subpoenaed to accept this reward.
Thank you for your time. You have the right to remain prideful.
Here you go. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
That's awesome. Mr. Schwartz, we have a serious situation we need to handle.
It says here you've been charged with being an awesome classmate who always gets his work done and helps others.
In light of these charges, you have been subpoenaed to accept this award.
Thank you for your time.
You have the right to remain awesome. Tell me what you gonna do, what you gonna do. Yeah. Bad boys, what you gonna do when they come for you. Bad boys, bad boys.
Let's talk about some school announcements.
Graduation will be held on Friday, May 18th. Students will only attend half of a day that day and will with the release time of 12 noon.
Prom tickets are on sale, $20 now until spring break, which means tomorrow is your last day to get them at a discount. After spring break, the price goes up.
Today will be auditions for the last drama club performance of the year. The Craving is a comedy about the dreams of a playwright going downhill as Hollywood destroys his masterpiece. Auditions will be in G305 from 5 to 6:30 on Thursday. Cast lists will be posted on Friday.
Big shout out to Ethan Leaflighter for making the commitment to join the U.S. Marine Corps. Also, a big shout out to the Culinary Arts Program. They raised $1,000 for the Sepsis Foundation during the Cupcake Wars. That sure was a tasty way to support a great cause. Visit Miss Pym at Gallery Gifts and Bridal in downtown Henderson and save $40 to $50 on all prom tuxedo rentals. You also receive a free pocket square and an $8 value. And Miss Pym donates $5 to our project graduation for every tuxedo she rents for our school's prom.
All charges in the cafeteria will be cut off tomorrow, March 30th.
Thank you for tuning into this week's episode of the CCM. Stay tuned after our sign-up for information on how you can connect with us on Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.
As always, we'll be back next time letting you know what's going on in your world. Have a great day, County. I'm Jacob Latimer.
And I'm Bailey Gardner, signing out.
Miami. South Beach, bringing the heat. Can y'all feel that? Can y'all feel that? Jig it out. Here I am in the place where I come let go. In Miami, the bass and the sunset low. Every day like a Mardi Gras. Everybody party all day. No work, all play, okay? So we sip a little something, leave the rest to spill. Me and Charlie at the bar running up a high bill. Nothing less than ill when we dress to kill. Every time the ladies pass, they be like, can y'all feel me? All ages and races, real sweet faces. Every different nation, Spanish, Haitian, Indian, Jamaican, black, white, Cuban or Asian. I only came for 2 days of playing, but every time I come, I always wind up staying. This the type of town I can spend a few days in. Miami, the city that keeps the roof blazing.
Party in the city where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
Welcome to Miami, bienvenido a Miami.
Bouncing in the club where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
I'm going to Miami. Yo, I heard the rainstorms ain't nothing to mess with, but I can't feel a drip on the strip. It's a trip, ladies half dressed, full of your quip, and they be screaming out, so I'm thinking I'ma scoop me something hot in this South Summer Merengue Mountain Pot. Hottest club in the city and it's right on the beach. Temperature, get to ya, it's about 500 degrees in the Caribbean seas with the hot mommies screaming. Every time I come to town, they be spotting me in the drop Bentley, ain't no stopping me. So cash in your dough and flow to this fashion show, pound for pound anywhere you go. Yo, ain't no city in the world like this, and if you ask how I know, I got to plead the fifth. Chi-town got it going on, and New York is the city that we know don't sleep. And we all know that LA and Philly stay jiggy, but on the sneak, Miami bringing heat for real. Y'all don't understand, I never seen so many Dominican women with sentiment tans. Mira, this is the plan, take a walk on the beach, draw a heart in the sand. Give me your hand, damn you look sexy. Let's go to my yacht in the West Keys, ride my jet skis, lounge under the palm trees. Cause you gotta have cheese for the summer house piece on South Beach. Water so clear you can see to the bottom. $100,000 cars, everybody got them. Ain't no surprise in the club to see Sly Stallone. Miami, my second home.
Party in the city where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
Welcome to Miami, bienvenido a Miami.
Bouncing in the club where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
I'm going to Miami.
Welcome to Miami.
Party in the city where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
Welcome to Miami.
City where the heat is